Hi students, today we will discuss about the basic concept of the thermodynamics. You know, thermodynamics is the most important chapter of the chemistry. Myself, Tanmoy Dotto, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, GIS College of Engineering, welcome you all in my first lecture of thermodynamics. What is the thermodynamics? Generally, thermodynamics is the motion of heat. Thermo means heat and dynamics means motion. So today we'll discuss about the most basic term of the thermodynamics. Like, first of all, you have to know in the thermodynamics that what is the system. Because without system, there is nothing. So what we are doing, we have to concentrate on the system. So what is the system? You have to know at first. You have to know what is the surroundings. What is the surroundings? Then you have to know what is the universe. Okay, so system, surrounding, universe, these all the terms are very much important, which you have to know very well. Then you have to know different kinds of properties, like intensive property. If you think about the different kinds of properties, then you have to know what is the intensive property and what is the extensive property, with some examples are there, because intensive property and extensive property, these two are very much important for the thermodynamics. So these two are very much important, intensive property and extensive property. When we discussed about the system, then there are three types of system also you have to know, like open system, like closed system, like isolated system. So open, closed and isolated, these things also you have to know, or we will discuss about the what is the open system, what is the closed system and what is the isolated system. Then you have to know that process. Okay, process means any kind of change, this is called the process. So there are actually different kinds of process are there, like starting from isothermal. Okay, so if you think about the process, then there is a process like isothermal. So what is the isothermal process? You have to know what is the isothermal process. So we'll discuss about the isothermal process. We'll discuss about the adiabatic process. We'll discuss about the adiabatic process. We'll discuss about the isochoric or isochoric process. Isochoric or isochoric process. We'll discuss about the isobaric process. Isobaric process. Then you have to know what is the state and the what is the state function. Okay, a path function. The different kinds of two kinds of functions are there, either state function or path function. So you have to know the state function and the path function also. So these all the topics we will discuss in details. Okay, because before going to the first law, second law, then you have to know, you should have a clear knowledge about the this kind of basic terms of the thermodynamics. So today we'll start from these basic terms. Then in the next class we'll start the first law of thermodynamics. Okay, so without further delay, let's go to the presentation. So first of all, what is the thermodynamics? Thermodynamics means, it is the Greek word. Okay, so thermo means heat. Thermo means heat, and dynamics means it is the motion. So thermodynamics means motion of heat. Okay, so now if we consider the thermodynamics, then it is the branch of science which deals with the study of different form of energy. That means heat, when heat is converted to the energy, this is the one thing. That means when different kind of energy will convert from one form to another form, that is indicated here, that with deals with the study with a different form of energy and the quantitative relationship between them. So the complete study of thermodynamics is based upon three generalization called first, second and third law of thermodynamics. That means we can explain the thermodynamics, overall concept of the thermodynamics, by that three principles: first law of thermodynamics, second law of thermodynamics, and obviously by third law of thermodynamics. So first of all, we have to know the basic basic concept of the thermodynamics. That means there are some terms which are very much important for the thermodynamics. So before going to the each and every principle, that means a first law, second law, third law, we have to know these kinds of terms. Okay, these terms are very much important. Okay, so first of all, if we consider the term, that first term is the system. What is the system? System means what we choose for our observation. This overall area is called actually system. That means our chosen area, it should be separated with a particular boundary from the outside. So system means it is the specified part of the universe which is under observation is called the system, and the remaining portion of the universe which is not a part of the system is called the surrounding. That means whatever the part outside of the system, this will be called, or that will be called the surrounding. And obviously system plus the surrounding equals to the universe. I can show you here. Look, if we consider any area, for example, this is any area. Okay, this area we choose for our observation. Okay, so this is the area which we choose for our observation. So this area will be called, this is the system. Okay, so this is the system. But whatever outside of the system, that means whatever the part of the outside of the system, these all the parts are called actually surrounding. That all the part are called surrounding. So what is the things which can differentiate the system and the surrounding, or which is the barrier of the system and surrounding? This will be called the boundary. So look here, that this barrier actually exists between system and surrounding. So this barrier is called actually boundary. Okay, so here the three terms are very much important. Look here, so first one is the system. System means which we consider for our observation, this will call the system. What is the surrounding? Surrounding means which exists outside of the system, this will be surrounding. And obviously there is a boundary which separate system and the surrounding. Now what is the universe? Simple. Universe means, what is the universe? Universe means system plus surrounding, this will call the universe. So system plus surrounding, or this will call the universe. So with this system and the surrounding, this is the summation of the system and surrounding, and this will called universe. This will called universe. Clear? I think clear. Okay, so system, surrounding, and universe, what we'll discuss in the thermodynamics, these three terms are very much important, which you have to keep in mind and which you have to understand properly. What is the system, what is the surrounding, and what is the universe? Okay, now when we discuss about the system, then there must be some kinds of system. There are different kinds of systems are there. So first of all, if we classify the system, so first one is the isolated system, second one is the closed system, and third one is the open system. So I will show you one by one. So if we consider, the first one is the isolated closed and open. So first I will show the open system. What is the open system? Open system means it's very simple. If you take this is any container, okay? So this is any container, and here in the container, for example, here there is a water, okay? You are taking water, but the container is not covered by any kind of things. That means the container is not the closed container. So if you take this kind of container where this is the open, then you can add heat here, no problem. And obviously you can add water here. That means water, whatever the substance present in the container. So both the things you can add there. So when you can add both the things, that means it is called the open system. Open system. So what is the meaning of open system? Open system means you can consider, open system means it is here. You can add the energy. Energy can be transferable, or mass can be transferable. Energy and mass both can be changed. This system will call the open system. Simple. If you take one glass of water, if you take milk in any container, aluminium container, then you can give the heat to the milk. And you can add the milk if it is not closed one. So this is very simple. This is called the open system. Now what is the closed system? If we consider the closed system, what will be the closed system? Closed system means simple, what you have to do? Just cover the container, okay? Just cover the container. If you cover the container, then it is not possible to add anything in the container. That means you can't add the mass, isn't it? So when we consider the closed system, when you consider the closed system, then there only energy can be transferable, but mass cannot be transferable. Okay, so only energy can be transferable, but there is no scope of the transferable of the mass, because if it is closed one, then obviously there is no scope of addition of the further either milk or whatever you are taking in the substance. There is no further scope of the addition. So that's why you can't change the mass of the container. But if it is metal container, then easily you can apply the heat in the container, isn't it? So if it is possible to apply the heat, then what happened? Then their energy can be changed. You know, heat is one kind of energy, so energy can be changed. So if energy can be changed, then obviously it is called the closed system. Now come to the third point. This is the isolated system. So it is very important if you consider the isolated system. Now here, in the same way, just think about that if this container is sealed by the any kind of insulator. That means if you take the tea or the milk in a thermoflux, then what happened? Their heat cannot be come out. That's why we're using the thermoflux, because the temperature of the materials which you take in the thermoflux, that should be here for a long time, either it is cold one or hot one or whatever. That means energy cannot be transferred from the substance to surrounding. So these kind of systems are called isolated system. Isolated system means their heat and energy both cannot be transferable. You can't add the heat there, you can't add the mass there, or you can't change the energy there. This is called the isolated system. So there are mainly three types of system which we choose for our observation according to the requirement of the condition. We can apply either it is the open system or closed system or the isolated system. So you have to keep in mind. Simply you have to keep in mind in this way from your daily life experience. You are taking what tea in open, any open utensil, any open container. This is the open system where you can add the tea, you can remove the tea, you can give the heat. Okay, so energy and mass can be transferable, open system. And closed one means here the container is closed. That means you can't add the mass, or you can't take the mass from the container. That means mass cannot be changed, but you can apply still if it is made by any kind of conductor materials. By the container is made by any kind of heat conducting materials, then you can apply the heat. So you can apply the heat to the container or to the materials which is present in the container. So this way, this is called the actually the closed system. An insulator, if you take the materials in the isolated any kind of thermoflux, okay, this will be the isolated system, okay. And this is very, very important. You have to keep in mind the three types of system. Okay, so this is the open system. So depending on the heat and mass change, we are taking these three types of system. But other than these three types of system, there are in different way we can classify the systems also. For example, look here. So first one is the homogeneous system. If you think about the homogeneous system, that a system is said to be homogeneous when it is the completely uniform throughout the mixture. That means what materials you are taking for the observation, that all the materials should be one type of things. Okay, so a homogeneous system is made of one phase only. Keep in mind, okay. Example, a pure single solid, okay, what you are taking a only pure single solid, or liquid or gas. They should not be mixing like solid to liquid, like you are taking anything which is solid in the liquid materials. This will not be the homogeneous. Homo means same time, isn't it? So homogeneous mixture means obviously it will be same time. So then the next way, in the other way, what will be the heterogeneous? Heterogeneous means obviously there'll be not the phase will not be the same, that the mixture of the phase may be present, like you know that there are some examples also, like ice in contact with water. Okay, ice and water, solid and liquid, so these are the different phases. So this will be obviously this will be the heterogeneous phase. Okay, so ice in water, there may be some two immiscible liquids at there. Okay, two insoluble solid in contact with a liquid in contact with vapor. So different kinds of phase may be present, and different kinds of mixture of the phases will present. Now we'll call it the heterogeneous system. Okay. Then macroscopic, in the other way we can differentiate or we can classify also, that macroscopic system. So macroscopic system means a macroscopic system is one there are a large number of particles, maybe molecules, atoms, ions present. So macroscopic system is one which there in which there there are large number of particles. Okay, there are many number of particles are present. This will call the macroscopic system. Okay, so macroscopic properties, what is the macroscopic, now come to the point, that what is the macroscopic properties. Okay, so property, first of all, what is the property? Property means by which we can express the any kind of system or any kind of material. So thermodynamics deal with matter in terms of the bulk, okay, large number of chemical species behavior, like properties of the system which arise from the bulk behavior of the matter called macroscopic properties. Okay, then which come from the bulk behavior, not in the atomic level, okay, not in the very molecular level. So thermodynamics does not deal with the microscopic level. It deals with the properties in the macroscopic level. This is the another side of the thermodynamics which you have to keep in mind, that thermodynamics always deals with the macroscopic system. It not deals with the microscopic system. Okay, this is another thing. And now the example of macroscopic, there are some examples of macroscopic properties are like, you know, that the pressure, that the volume, that temperature, that surface tension, then viscosity, density, that all are the examples of the macroscopic system. Okay, so these all are the examples of the macroscopic system. So now if you consider the macroscopic properties, then the macroscopic properties can be divided into the two categories. So first one is the intensive property. Okay, so there are two types of property. First one is the intensive property. So this is very, very important, which you have to keep in mind. So if you consider the intensive property, they look here, the properties which do not depend on the quality of matter present in the system. So intensive property means which do not depends on the quality of the matter present in the system. That means generally it does not depends on the mass of the materials. Okay, so intensive properties are those properties which do not depends on the mass of the properties or amount of the property. It is independent. You can keep in mind that intensive property independent on the amount. For example, that pressure, you know, pressure will not depend on the amount. Okay, so like what pressure you are getting from a substance, if you remove its amount, it will be the same types of pressure. Temperature, okay, density, specific heat, surface tension, okay, that all are the independent on the amount. So these are called the intensive property. Now there is another kind of properties also there, which are called actually extensive property. So extensive property means it is the properties which depends on the properties which depends on the magnitude of the quantity of the matter. Okay, that means if you decrease the quantity or the amount of the matter, then obviously there are some properties which will be changed if you remove the quantity or if you remove the amount. Okay, for example, you know, total mass, obviously if you decrease the amount, so total mass will be obviously decreased. Okay, so if you think about the volume, if you think about the internal energy, okay, so if you think about the enthalpy, these all are the properties which are additive in nature. Additive in nature means, this is a very important word, additive in nature means, so if you add the amount, okay, so a plus a, so it will be the 2a. So what happens if you a plus a, 2a means the amount plus amount means it's the double amount. So it totally depends on the additive nature. And if you add the amounts more and more, then obviously its property, this particular property will change. Okay, so this you have to keep in mind, that extensive properties are the obviously it depends on the amount. So this is very, very, very important. You have to keep in mind, okay? So that mainly, okay. So mainly there are two kinds of properties are there, okay? So one is the intensive property. You have to keep in mind. First one is the intensive property. Intensive property means it depends on amount. Okay, so clearly it independent on amount. Okay, for example, if you think about the example will be the temperature. Okay, so temperature will be the property which is independent on the amount. So temperature is the intensive property. Another way, there is another property which we'll call the extensive property. So extensive property means extensive property means you have to keep in mind, it depends on amount. It depends on amount. For example, if you take the example of mass, that all depends on the amount of the particular substance. That means if you increase the amount, then obviously this kind of properties will be increased. So this is very, very important. You have to keep in mind what is the extensive property and what is the intensive property. What is the states of the system and state variables? Okay, so macroscopic properties which determine the state of the system are referred to as the state variables. Okay, so state variables means it is the function or thermodynamic parameter. Change of the state properties depends only upon the initial and final, that is called the states of the system, but it is independent of the manner which the change has brought about. That means simply I can tell you that that the property will be state function, that the it will be state function if the change of this kind of function will depends on only the initial and final stage. It will not depends on the pathway or how the change occurred. Then this will call the state function. If it depends on the its pathway, that how the change occurred, then it will not be called the state function, it will be called the path function. Like work depends on the its pathway, that how the change occurred. So work will be called the path function. Okay, that means it is not the state function. So state function are those functions which depends on only initial and final stage. It will not depends on that how the change or in through which pathway the change occur. This is called the state function. Okay, or if it depends on the pathway, it called the path function. I will discuss later in the next class, maybe or next to next class, then in details what is the state function or like that. So then the next thing is that which we have to know, it is the thermodynamic equilibrium. A system is said to have the attained state of thermodynamic equilibrium when it shows no further tendency to change its property with time. This is the general thing of the equilibrium. Equilibrium means at a glance it seems like there will be no change of any kind of this particular property with the time. This is called the equilibrium. So the criteria of the thermodynamic equilibrium requires the following three types of equilibrium exist simultaneously in a system. Keep in mind, to be the system in the thermodynamic equilibrium, the three different types of equilibrium conditions should be fulfilled simultaneously. So first one is the chemical equilibrium, a system in which the composition of the system remain fixed and definite. That means chemical composition will not be changed. To get the thermodynamic equilibrium, chemical composition will not be changed. This is the first condition. Second condition, mechanical equilibrium. Mechanical equilibrium means no chemical work is done between different parts of the system or between the system and the surrounding. It can be achieved by keeping pressure constant. Okay, so no such kind of work will be done to the different parts of the system or between the system and the surrounding. Then it will be called the, it is in the mechanical equilibrium. Third condition is the most important condition in the thermodynamics. Then this will be the thermal equilibrium. Okay, it is a thermal equilibrium. That means temperature remain constant and no flow of heat between system and surrounding. This is very very important, because if there is no flow of the heat, then only it will be in the thermal equilibrium. Okay, so otherwise it will not achieve the thermal equilibrium. So thermal equilibrium is very much important factor, and a system will be in the thermodynamic equilibrium when it will be possible. It will be possible only when the three equilibrium, chemical, mechanical and the thermal equilibrium, will be achieved simultaneously. Not only one is sufficient, simultaneously three equilibrium should be in a system, then only we call, okay, this is in the thermodynamic equilibrium. Okay, now come to the next topic which you have to know, process. Okay, so first of all, what is the process? It is the thermodynamic process is called, it is the it is one kind of, when the thermodynamic system change from one state to another, the operation is called the process. Okay, the various types of process are there. Okay, so when the thermodynamic system changes from one state to another, the operation is called a process. The various types of process present is that this change, actually any kind of change from one form to another form, these kind of changes are called actually process. Okay, so there are three types of process are there. First one is the isothermal process, second one is the adiabatic process. So then there are so many types, not three types, there are so many types of process. I will discuss one by one. So first one, isothermal process. So from the name it should be clear that isothermal means there should not be any change of the temperature, okay? So the process should, that means change from one form to another form, this will be at constant temperature, okay? When it will be in constant temperature, this will be called the isothermal process, okay? So in at this time, delta T will be zero, D indicate the change and T is the temperature, so delta T will be zero, and you know that internal energy that corresponding to the temperature. So if dT equal to zero, so look here, obviously your del E will be also zero. So if it is the isothermal process, you have to keep in mind, if it is the isothermal process, then obviously the change of the internal energy, that will be always zero, okay? So now come to the second types of process. This is the adiabatic process, okay? So what is the adiabatic process? If you think about the adiabatic process means when their heat will be constant, okay? So first one is the temperature, isothermal. Second one is the adiabatic, that means the heat, okay? So if you consider the adiabatic process, this process will take place when delta Q equals to zero. That means change of heat. No heat will come to the system, or no heat will come out to the from the system. Okay. So then this will be called, the system is thermally isolated. Thermally isolated. Okay. So there should not be any chance of coming the heat or go outside from the system. Okay. So this will call the adiabatic process. Third is the isobaric process. So isobaric process means in this process the pressure remain constant throughout the change, okay? So here in case of isobaric process, you have to keep in mind that the delta P, change of pressure, will be zero. So look here delta P equals to zero, there will be no change of the pressure when system change from one form to another form, okay? So next is the isochoric or isochoric, whatever you prefer to call it. So isochoric or isochoric process, that in this process their volume will be constant. There should not be change of the volume when there this kind of change occurs. So it is isochoric or isochoric, whatever, the you have to maintain the constant volume when change occur, okay? So isochoric process or isochoric process is the delta V equals to zero, okay? So then the next type is the cyclic process. Look here, what is the cyclic process? In case of cyclic process, when a system undergoes a number of different process and finally return to its original position, okay? That means overall change will be zero, okay? So when a system, there are different changes are one by one changes are there, but finally it comes to its initial stage, that will be called the cyclic process. So if I show you that what are the types of process, then I can show you in short that first one is the delta E equals to zero, and this will call the isothermal process, where delta T equals to zero, change of temperature will be zero, first one. Second one, dq, okay, delta q or dq will be zero, because this is the adiabatic process, there will be no change of the heat, no change will can enter to the system, no heat can go outside of the system. This will call the adiabatic process. And the third one is the dp equals to zero, that means it is the isobaric process, that means pressure will not be changed in the process or in the when change occur, okay? And the next one is the isochoric or isovolumic, where delta V will be zero. And the fifth one is the cyclic process, that means it is the process when defined kinds of change occur and finally it comes to its initial position, and this type of process is called, actually it is the cyclic process, okay? So now this is the overall idea about the things, and then most important topic of the thermodynamics regarding the process which you have to know. The first one is the reversible process, another one is the irreversible process. Reversible process and irreversible process, these two things are very, very important for you, which you have to know in details, but we will discuss these two things in the next class. So before that, what you have to keep in mind properly that in the thermodynamics there are some parameters which you have to understand properly, starting from the what we discussed today, starting from the what is the thermodynamics, thermodynamics, the motion of the heat or the flow of the heat. Then there are some concept of the system surrounding, there's a concept of the boundary, there's a concept of the isolated system, there's a concept, there's different kinds of system, there are closed system and obviously open system. There are three types of systems which is very much important and with which we have to deal. Okay, will deal with this kind of things. Then there are some homogeneous system, there are some heterogeneous system. Homogeneous system means it is the same phase, heterogeneous means it is the different phase. Then macroscopic system, macroscopic properties are there. Then intensive property, this is also very very important, intensive property and the extensive property. And I told you that in case of intensive property it is independent on the mass, and in case of extensive property it totally depends on mass or amount. Okay, so this is very very important. Then states of the system, different kinds of states are there. Then state function, which depends on only initial and final states, but path function, which depends on the how the change occurred. Then thermodynamic equilibrium is very much important, when it achieve the three kinds of equilibrium, chemical, mechanical and thermal, and then finally come to the different kinds of process. But process is not concluded here, because we will discuss the two important different kinds of processes. One is the isothermal, one is the reversible, and another is the irreversible process. So I meet with you in the next class with these topics. Goodbye, take care.